Zombie apocalypse.
Because you have drunk the barrel dry?
Damn beer stat. His household is as poorly run as his lands.
Estrid is a good wife. It's far better than he deserves.
You would say that, Adrian. Your wife acts like a sow in a skirt.
Might swear to run as a worthy woman, you coxcomb. But she's an excellent cook.
With a fine nose for truffles.
If Birsten does not return soon, wine will not be the only thing spilled upon his floor.
Gentlemen, everyone is fractious with this waiting. Let's just be civil at least.
Him is that Ilche Ervo from Northman Swahir.
It's terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
gods will come at one cry from me.
Sheathe your blade, lady. I'm Ivor of the Raven Clan, here at your husband's request.
Another Dane. I am Estrid, wife of the Lord of Essex. As you may have heard, my lord is not at home.
I'm wary of rounding up Saxons. Is your husband stolen, drunk, or wayward?
He'll be stalking the woodlands today, hunting game and ignoring the vital affairs of Essex. One such affair is why we called for you.
If I can find him, I'll remind him of his duties.
Ah, such would be a miracle. His favorite haunt is southwest of here. The lavender fields there attract the prey, God help him.
With luck, he hasn't been eaten, but I'll return either way.
Patience is a godly virtue, Adrid.
Even the saints would tire of waiting for Beerstan to hang up his bow. Dear Estrid, we must discuss the affairs of this land, with or without him.
Where was the bishop, Sitana?
This place would have been impressive once, a long time ago.
Let's rip the door! No longer, corpse!
together, lads. We have this.
What do you see?
Hunting is a fine sport, but I hope the Ultiman has not become the prey. No good comes from a camp this bloody. The remains of the hunting party. This one was savaged by a large animal. Guard as they supped. Attacked by a beast. Something strong enough to kill the horse. Some large prey left these tracks in the grass. Hunters were prey to a large beast or two. I can only hope that Bjerstan still lives.
Show me.
Bjerstan,
ready your weapon, or accept your fate as a feast for bears. It's the Black Glossy! Ah, we'll fight to the death, worthy one! Do not let me... Before, I would not have survived this ambush without you. You have my gratitude to stumble upon me in my moment of greatest peril. Perhaps you were godsend.
I'm Estrid sent. Your wife and the Thanes of Essex both want your balls on a blacksmith's anvil.
When do they not? You could return and report that the savage claw took me. Poor Bjerstan, his exit pursued by a bear.
And make the beast Lord of Essex in your stead.
No doubt my Estrid would prefer his velvet paws to my calloused hands. So, who are you? A cell sword?
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan. You hinted at an alliance for the loan of my unique talents.
S'blood, yes. Let us return to Colchester at once, and we'll speak more of the delicate matter on my mind. I'm glad you answered my summons. I did not expect such a skilled fighter.
It's good I came when I did. Lost men end on this hunt.
Good men, all. They will have the proper rights, and their families will be cared for.
Your people sacrificed much for your sport.
They did. There is no balm for my tortured heart.
Why did you ask me here?
Do you believe in true love, Eivor?
I have loved.
Have you truly? Has a longing burned in your breast, a sweet lingering pain, paralyzing you with its sting?
There's pain enough in battle. I do not seek it out in love.
I long for it. The thrill of a fight softly won. My wife Estrid lacks fire. She is a fish out of water, cold and dead.
She showed great passion when I met her, keeping her thanes in check.
Oh, they love her, it is true. Some with too much devotion. And I have not been a good and attentive husband. I have always been a plucked goose in matters of love, and a piss-poor ruler to boot.
Strong must be the hand that steers the ship, Piston.
My hand would rather tug the catgut of a well-crafted bow, my eyes narrowing at the sight of Rey.
Aye, a crown's heavy on the head.
Then let us run wild and free in the woods as the wolves do. Live on our wits, prowl and stalk and feast.
You have a romantic way about you, Biston.
Do not fret. My guards will not worry you when we are together.
You mismark me if you think I'm capable of worry. Have you built your city in the ruins of another?
No, these builders are lost to the annals of time. Far advanced of the Saxon hobbles of Wattle and Daub, I have ambition to build a great palace myself, with mosaics and balmy courtyards.
What stops you?
That which stops all but the most creative minds. Coin, imagination, talent.
And your people? Is Essex happy?
That is a question I never really ponder. I suppose they are. I hope they are. Alfred believes I rule like a chickless hen, flapping and squawking over at the farmer's dinner.
He interferes.
No, he disapproves. Is that not infinitely worse? But look, we are nearing my hall. I must face the wolves at my door before we discuss your offer to Essex, Eivor.
It may be I can speed your business along.
Fend off the spears of their displeasure.
Let them speak their woes. I'll advise you if I can.
Who is this owl, Bearston, that twitters in your ear?
An advisor, nothing more. Here to help Essex navigate her brewing storms. Now, my dear brethren, Adred, perhaps you'll start us off. What troubles you?
You're a disgrace, Bearston. Couldn't get a sow in an alehouse. Alfred's men are crawling all over Essex.
King Alfred, yes. Though it is within his right, the constant presence of his men is certainly an issue. An issue that must be dealt with, indeed. And you, Wyatt, what do you say?
Your preparations for the Lammas Festival. How can you think of spending so much coin when your people are starving?
Drink, be merry, eat your fill. Sing of great battles, for tomorrow we may die. There's no problem that mead and song can't solve.
Do we not deserve such mirth? A great feast and happiness? The dark days of winter approach. Let us drink them away. And Aldrich, do you yap like a she-hound as Aedred does?
You know my thoughts, Bearston. The Feared. How can we give men to Alfred for his wars when our harvest suffers day by day?
Refuse to send your men. Let Alfred's people die for his hopeless cause against the Norse.
Then we refuse.
Refuse our king? Has madness taken your wits, Bearston?
There. Have I not answered all your questions?
You are a stain on this shire, Bearston. Useless.
Useless?
That's right. Yet still you haunt my hall. Be gone. I haven't time for your squabbling. You're certainly a better hunter than you are a diplomat, Eivor.
I spend my life where it matters most.
All this talk of hunting makes me long for the woods.
Your wife awaits, Bearston. Aren't you worried some other... Your wife awaits, Bearston. Aren't you worried some other man will drench your sheets with his sweat?
She does as she must. As do I. But you will discover this soon enough.
Done the impossible, Dane. Returned my errant gander to his coop.
My pettish love. Such a stormy countenance clouds the sun of my return.
Your thanes drank the ale the abbot gifted us. All of it.
Now that is a tragedy my heart will not easily overcome.
If he looked at me with the same affection he shows for hunting deer, our marriage might have survived.
I notice your love has gone sour. Was it fresher than this?
There is so little difference between love and hate. It's difficult to say where the sourness comes from.
So, what do you need of me?
Our affairs are more of heart than of state, Eivor. What little passion there was between us faded into bickering long ago.
We would have our freedom, Eivor. I from my wife, and my wife from Essex.
I'm too sharp a weapon for so soft a task. Why not part and be done with it?
Oh, were I a Dane, and divorce as simple as a slit throat. But it's not so easy as that.
Then what is stopping you? Your King Alfred?
Ours was not a union of love, but necessity. Decreed by Alfred's father to strengthen ties with Francia. Not easily broken.
Explain yourselves, clear and plain, and I will do it. The poetry here is mind mud.
We had a plan, a simple plan. A woman lost and a woman found.
Some time ago, we paid a Dane to kidnap me and ferry me safely to Francia. As you can see, he did not deliver.
He was certainly thorough in other regards.
Some Norse can be quick to take coin and slow to earn it. If I give my word, it is not broken.
Could we try the kidnap again? Much of the planning is done. It would only take a more trustworthy overseer.
It should be a bold venture if we do. Loud and brash, and seen by all.
During our Lammas festival, merry peasants and guards with wandering eyes.
Your return to Francia would need a swift ship, with a captain ready to leave England.
We could ask him.
I would have thought his steed and seamen spent.
Come find me in the market, Eivor. Our unwelcome guests require food and ale to soften their anger.
My wife is a gracious and attentive host, Eivor. The only thing that keeps my braying thanes at bay.
And the woman found?
A darling Maybud, Alvida, my childhood sweetheart. I left her 20 years ago in Molden to marry my prickled pear.
20 years? Can an ember so cold be reignited?
We can hope. You must fan the flame. Find her, bring her to my lakeside cottage, and light a bonfire there. I will know to come. I believe she lived in the last house in Molden. A small, sweet place, where fond memories were made.
I will do as you both ask, and ask Freya for success in this love game.
Good luck in your endeavors, Eivor. I pray you find my Alvida with a fair face and a yearning heart.
Now, should I look for Alvida first, or meet with Estrid at the marketplace?
lover from so long ago. Would I?
Show me what lies ahead.
The last house in Molden. Olvina should be here.
Someone was interrupted preparing the supper. Taken or fled.
Spilt pail of water. Someone was in a hurry.
Leave me be, Warmonger! You have my sister! Is that not enough?
Peace, boy. I'm not with these men. I came to speak with your sister, that's all.
A Dane in Essex. Here's a day riddled with strange portents and happenings.
What is your name?
I'm Ellerich, the man of this house. Who are you? And why have you come?
I'm looking for your sister at the behest of another.
Behest? I've got no money to speak of, and my sister is well past the marrying age.
Do you know where they're holding Olvida?
Yet another stay at the king's pleasure. The prison camp at Brentwood. Far to the west.
I'll bring her to the lake house north of there. Meet us there if you wish.
If you promise you will find her, I will.
Stretch your wings, Sunan.
Sonic! Go!
Why are you following me? My sister is in peril.
But it's not the healthiest.
Heathen!
Christ!
Thor lends me strength.
Wait!
Time to
go!
Die.
Get the murdering dog!
Must be careful now.
Sunin, guide me.
See, Sunan. This key should unlock Alvida's cage. This must be Birsten's love, Alvida. They haven't broken her spirit.
What? What is this? You're not one of them!
Stay quiet. We're here to free you.
I can't walk. My ankle.
Now we'll carry you.
Who are you? Who risked so much to save me?
And?
Of Elurch's. Is he all right? The poor boy?
Not your brother. Someone else who wishes to rekindle a friendship.
Gentler, please.
You'll soon be safe. Rest easy.
Ah, my leg. It pains.
We're almost there.
Beat me. My bones ache.
Bless the saints! Here you are, sister, safe and well.
Gentler, please.
You'll soon be safe. Rest easy.
My ankle.
Rest now. Soon you will be up and about again.
Alvida! Did they hurt you?
Takes more than some cocksure milksops to break my will. Beating a boy half to death for stealing bread? I'll not see it done.
Growling bellies mean nothing to those pay swords.
Elurch, pay more mind to the world. It is cruel and dark for those who cannot stand up for themselves.
Alvida, could we speak in private?
He is a good boy.
You raised him alone.
Dead of the plague that came when... Now it's your turn. Love him.
He does.
I've thought of him sometimes.
He has thought of nothing but you.
How it would work between me and...
He'll come if you...
Elurch!
My...
It is?
They still...
I.
And do you...
And this young lad is Elurch,
All that is proper. Hello, your worshipfulness.
I am
19 summers.
He's all the family I have, Bert.
We have one half. Does this mean we're leaving?
You are, my boy. To live
or you go.
Now to plan the kidnap. Estrid waits for me.
Dear Bearston, I cannot believe you would come for me after all these years.
I never stopped thinking of you, Alvidan.
I've been Colchester, a gooseberry in the Elderman's patch.
Selfie.
La
you are, Ivor. Over here.
They are. Though time will tell if the fire is rekindled.
And now my marriage awaits your executioner's sword.
Will it not be strange to leave this place? You've lived here half your life.
Yes, but what is to keep me here? A loveless union and the dirt mounds of two babes who never took a breath.
Have you always missed Francia?
I have. Or rather, I miss the woman I was when I lived there. Somewhat freer and more hopeful.
And what of our plan, the great Lammas kidnap? Is this a Christian feast?
Yes, it's a wonderful evening, a blessing of the harvest, full of fruits and fires, drinking and dancing.
Revelers, with muddy minds and glazed eyes. That's good for us. And what of the ship that will sail you home?
I know just the one, and her captain is full of fire. Come, I will take you to him.
Well, come on there.
This captain, who's he?
Not much more than a boy in his 17th year, full of youthful bravado.
A Saxon?
A Dane, though Adred calls you raiders. He says that you are here to steal England.
Some may be. But I've come to settle a stretch of land. I'm not so keen to return to the winters of my birth in Norway.
Norway? Ah! It must be beautiful. Rugged and fearsome, and cold as anything, the frozen north.
So cold that light hangs in the sky. A road for the Valkyries who carry our dead warriors to their eternal feast.
An eternal feast would be a merry end. We are here.
There's a brother.
The captain's name is Hrolfr, called Rollo in my tongue. Tell him of our new plan and agree to whatever reward he demands. He may take some convincing, for we did not part on the best of terms.
I'll bring him round. By force or persuasion. Just be ready for my signal at the Lammas Festival.
Rollo! Please, I'm just a poor Christian brother with nothing left to give.
Someone's at the door, Rollo.
Oh, is it that Hun I asked for?
Estrid sent me.
Did she now? As a parting gift for the man who rattled her bones, huh?
No, I'm here to collect you.
Can it wait?
Oi! Bring out the one they call Rollo. The king's men want to ask him a few questions.
No!
Just a second. Day, sir. Come in.
Move! Some help here!
Bloody fucking Danes! Open this door! Out! Now!
Follow me!
We found your camp, Dane! Your friends are all...
Estrid did not lie. You have fire.
And who are you to Estrid?
Only a friend. I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Norse by the music of your speech.
Then you must forgive me. Those seconds knew about my camp. I was mind-drunk to leave my warriors behind.
Go to your men if you must. Only tell me where to find you. We have much to talk about.
Northeast of here, by the river's mouth. Follow me or come when you can.
Me, Eivor. I'll show you and the gods my worth. I will be patient, for honor and glory.
To me, warrior, let gold and glory be our meat and eat.
The Screamer, if you don't keep it down.
Was it you who gave Ivar the Boneless his name? I hear talk of his deeds around the campfire, but his name I never understood.
He was boneless before I met him. Now he's bones on a pyre. That's all I know for sure.
And Alfred, can you imagine their king in the sky blanket tear set in our land? He'd be bluer than my father on nights the mead is strong. He'd fall asleep in the snow with a dog keeping him warm. This talk makes me long for the old times. Good old times.
Yay! Cut you down!
Thank you.
people bound.
It's worse than I feared. So many of my people gone.
And the rest at each other's throats. They believe one of your number is a traitor.
Lork and Gerhild have been at my side all season. I don't like to doubt them, but my people are taken and my ship is gone.
If the traitor lives, all of you are at risk. Let me talk to them. The innocent have nothing to hide.
Very well. But do not let Loki whisper lies in your ear.
While you were drinking and whoring, Rollo, the Saxons attacked us. And these two were nowhere to be found.
Neither betrayed us, Ake. Gerhild, my sworn shield sister, and Lork served my father well.
Seems like the Saxons didn't get all of Rollo's clan. I should speak to both, and see if I can find some evidence around Gerhild, is it?
Aye. Rollo's sworn sword sister. I've served him proud and true. You cannot think I betrayed him?
You weren't here when the Saxons attacked.
I was hunting. There's fine game in the trees outside the camp, and our people need meat.
What was your prey?
Rabbits for stew. Rollo's favorite.
Who are you to Rollo?
I am shield sworn, so long as England and that Frankish witch do not sway him from the true path. Our people deserve better.
I hear envy, but of Estrid or Rollo, I cannot tell.
You know nothing, Ravenbeak. My concern is for my fellow Danes. You'll find no treachery here.
That's all for now. I should speak to both, and see if I can find some evidence around the camp. Nordic, yes? What is your story?
You want to hear my story? And bring me a mug of ale? And we'll sit and talk as equals. Elsewise, you can hang.
Where were you when the Saxons came?
Hunting rabbits, wasn't I? Sick to death of carrots and turnips. Then I heard Gerhild shouting, and all hell broke loose.
Did you see anything at all?
Gerhild talking with a Saxon. Couldn't hear them, but wasn't nothing good. Sure of that much.
Why should I believe you? You could be lying to save your own skin.
Ask her. Says she's loyal to Rollo, but I've known her since she was a babe. Full of spite and ambition, always was.
How long has your sword served Rollo?
I owe his father a blood oath. If that means wiping Rollo's arse until I die, so be it.
And if Rollo was dead, that oath would be fulfilled. You must tire of battle.
I'll feast in Odin's hall one day, but not with the stain of dishonor on my hands.
I have what I need for now. I might find some evidence to test their stories. To hunt, and the camp is full of fresh kills.
While you were drinking and whoring, Rollo, the Saxons attacked us. And these two were nowhere to be found.
Neither betrayed us, Ake. Gerhild is my sworn shield sister, and Lork served my father well.
Seems like the Saxons didn't get all of Rollo's clan. Spot to hide. Somewhere to wait out a Saxon attack. Gerhild, we speak again. Lork accused you of treachery. He saw you with a Saxon.
Lork? You believe that old crow? His bones crumble and his mind wanders with age. or he wallows in jealousy. Take your pick.
You're lying. I found racks and racks of game.
You've got more wit than your face suggests. I went to meet a lad from a nearby village. Rolo's not the only one who dallies with locals.
That's all for now. Lorg. You're lying. I found a rack full of game nearby, enough to feed the camp for days.
Told you! I was hunting.
Stick to that story, and I'll tell Rolo to take your treacherous head.
I was sleeping in the forest, wasn't I? Heard Saxons tramping through the trees, so I hid. Not fool enough to face him on my own.
I have what I need for now. Cast about this lad, my friend.
Have you made your decision?
Geralt claimed to be hunting as Lorg did. Rabbit.
She rarely hunts. She's been a terrible shot since we were children.
Your shield is jealous. She thinks you neglect your people by sleeping with the enemy.
She always had ambition. But she accepted my leadership. Swore on her shield.
Lorg saw her with a Saxon. She claimed he was her lover.
Yet she has berated me many times for taking Estrid to my bed. I did not think her a hypocrite.
Lorg said he was hunting, but your rags are full of fresh rabbits.
Why would he lie, unless he had something to hide?
He tires of his blood oath, and with your death, he would free.
He has become old and frail, but he served my father well. I would have freed him without bloodshed.
This man knew the Saxons were coming and hid. He was either in league with them or a coward.
A sad fall for a great warrior no longer in his prime. Have you come to a firm conclusion?
I have.
Let me hear it. Both choices will pain me, but let it be the truth.
Geralt betrayed you.
No! That's not true! Rolo, I beg you!
A shameful death on bloody Saxon soil.
Both had reason to betray their Jarl, but only one had the eyes on to do so. I hope you chose well, for you denied them a seat in my hall.
There can be no feast in Valhalla or break faith.
She was always a jealous crow, beak pricking over every decision I made.
Nothing more can be done here, but your warriors might still be alive, and I will need your help after they're free.
There's a Saxon camp with a dock at Port Walton. It might be they were taken there.
Always knew there was something wrong about her.
Spare me your sullen words! My heart is torn. Go, find something useful to do.
I've heard of a safer place than this south of Colchester. Let's you and I go take a look, shall we?
I'm sorry that your people suffer.
Thank you, Eivor. I have much to think on as we journey.
I'll leave you to those thoughts.
Thank you.
Yes, Zunan.
The guards here are vigilant.
These Rolo's men, caged like plump hens.
Idiot, press hard!
To your fate. Get round the side.
Rolo's men are free. And we discuss the terms of the kidnap. Your axe arm is strong, Rolo.
Never doubt me, Raven Feeder. These Saxon king slaves did.
These warriors want the leader, not a lovesick boy who spurns them for whores and meat.
You shame me, and rightly so. Love cuts deeper than an axe. But I'll dwell on the pain no longer. My people need me.
As do I. You owe me a debt. I call on it now.
My axe is yours. Speak.
I need someone with a swift wave steed in good repair to bring the Lady Estrid across the sea to Francia.
Another kidnap scheme. Estrid is unshakable. All right, then. Let we two triumph where one failed.
I need you stout-hearted in this. Whatever your passions for Estrid.
We had our time together. Now that's done. I will not fail you here, nor her.
We will meet with your men inside Colchester on the night of the Lammas Festival.
Yes, yes, one more. And only because you all have... Always nice to see a friendly face. So if you see any about, send them my way.
What do you have today? Have you got a contract for me?
Not only does this quest pay, but you get to have fun doing it. Probably. Remember, this person needs... I'd do it myself, but someone's got to stand around here and look busy.
I have to go. See you soon.
You go on, I'll still be here.
Yes, yes, one more. And only because you all have such good...
Have a look, Sunin.
Tell the guards you meet at Aemon. Go, Zulin.
friend of... They say it will bring you your true love.
Let us dance. Then perhaps you will see he has been beside all along.
Be my eye.
My head is spinning with the need to
fight. Yeah! Who was that? That put him and all those who stand there!
Get in there! Run home now! Then perhaps you will see he has been beside you.
How are your people, Rollo? Recovered and ready for what tonight holds?
Gerhild's treachery was a blow. Few were surprised it came to that, only that her dark ways took such a brutal turn. Put that aside. We're ready now. What would you have of us?
Wait for my signal. When I approach Estrid, that is your time.
I am your axe, Eivor.
Night will fall soon. Then is our moment to strike.
I couldn't help but overhear.
I wanted to wear a garland of meadow sweet in my hair. They say it will bring you your true love.
Let us dance. Then perhaps you will see he has been beside you all along.
I wanted to wear a garland of meadow sweet in my hair. They say it will bring you your true love.
Is Esther's friend ready with a silent
Lady of Essex is ours!
Saxon dogs, the Lady of Essex is ours.
Lady Estrid is kidnapped.
Odin,
those you all cower before your master.
You're coming with me.
Oh, oh, desist, you foul thane. Guards, oh, woe unto me. Put me down.
Odin's beard. You wouldn't fool a child with that howling.
We are safe enough to walk, I think. Aren't we? Oh, what a thrill! My heart is racing!
Be glad it still beats at all. Your screaming drew half the guards in Colchester down upon us.
I wanted to give good performance. My father always said I was quite the actor.
I won't deny your enthusiasm.
Did you not have even a little fun?
To steal away a princess. It did give a thrill.
A woman fights bravely against her abductors. Yet, what will they do with me now? Is my virtue safe with you?
It's not in danger, if that's what you mean.
Come now, Eivor. You can stand against Elfrid's brutes, but you shudder at a maiden's gentle teasing? It is done, and all that stands between me and my home now is a foaming ribbon of surf and silt.
You did well, Rollo. You and your people. Are you ready to sail?
Loki's hissing sun churns the waters between our coasts. We'll need time to rest as we wait for fairer weather.
Have a care, then. Alfred's soldiers will be looking for Istrid, even if Birsten's will not.
Now's not the time for such worry, Eivor. Tonight, we celebrate! Let's get you some mead!
Birstan will meet you northeast of Colchester tomorrow. You have earned all my husband promised, and more. Come find me, if you like, away from these reveling Danes.
Thor's thunderous hammer!
I should find Birsten. No doubt he's hunting again.
Yes! A ruse worthy of the trickster. Stolen by us, mere mortals.
The other side was barred. I need your eyes, my friend.
I am proud of us. We did a good thing for Istrid and her lord. Maybe now we can all be happy.
Made me feel young again. And I have you to thank.
You believed me, though I was a coward. Won't make that mistake again.
Survey the area, Sunan.
Lies ahead, I wonder.
A new life, or an old life nude?
My old life, Francia. Mon Dieu, I feel as if I have been sleepwalking these past years, waiting for something to shake me awake.
Are you awakened now?
Yes. These past weeks have been stirring. Breathtaking. Your passion and strength. Eivor, I've never met such a burning soul.
You make too much of it. All I've done, I did for my clan and the glory it brought me.
Why does your honesty make you more alluring still? Le cœur a ses raisons que la raison ne connaît point.
Did you dream while you sleepwalked?
I did. I dreamed that all my fleeting happiness was a prelude to something bigger. Glimpses of greater joy, greater love. Lie with me, Eivor, under the stars of England. Give me a last bittersweet moment before I leave her shores.
I'll be with you tonight. But tomorrow your new life must begin. I hope you won't look back. Shh. Still your lips and come here.
A fellow adventurer, need to know the lie of the land? My prices are competitive.
Yes, all right.
Now, show me your map. There is a place here.
Must be blocked from the other side. Not to draw attention here.
What? Getting tired.
See you, old friend.
There, there, old hound. Hold faith, for soon we'll be hunting.
Beirsten, Estrid said you'd be here.
Eivor, dear heart. You who drew back the bow of Eros and reunited me with my one true love.
Have your thanes asked why you do not look for Estrid?
Pish. They have asked, yes. I said it was hopeless. Then I lay upon my couch, sobbing and wailing. A pretty show.
That may not be enough.
Tut. The wind is soft upon our faces, and I am far from the whispering doors of Colchester. Come, let's hunt!
What are we hunting now?
Boar. A majestic animal, don't you think? Driven by a fierce fire, blazing eyes, and sword tusks.
I once knew a strong-armed shield maiden who rode a boar into battle. She named it Bristle.
How wondrously strange. Your tales are worthy of the hearing. We'll not ride our boars, but eat them. A feast, in Alvida's honor.
A feast for your mistress? Birsten, if this ruse falls apart, King Alfred will strip you of your title. Our alliance would be worthless.
Have no fear, I shall be discreet. We will eat and sup at my hall with a few friends and family. It is there our friendship will be sealed.
So soon after Lammas, will people there not recognize me?
No, you are just one more Dane. And in that chaos, who remembers anything but the screams of dear Estrid?
These are your lands. I trust in your judgment. And how is Alvida?
She is a firebrand. We have rekindled our love as if we were teenagers. Even Ellerich is a welcome addition. A younger brother to me, yet more alike to a son. The things I should like to teach him. Ah, this is the spot. The best boar here. Won't fill itself. I shall suck the scrumptious marrow from your bones, you porcine devil. Come on, the feast table won't fill itself. This table won't fill itself. Bow arm aches. We did well, Eivor.
A good hunt, Birsten.
And enough for one day, I think. Even my thanes will not go hungry with this catch, and they are as voracious as wolves snatching at my carcass.
They may give you grief, but I've been nothing but amused. They are a welcome change to warring jarls and piss-sudden politics.
You have brought us all true happiness, Eivor. I thank you from the bottom of a heart full up with joy.
Birsten, the heart hound, who sought his true love by searching the sad haven of his memory and finding her there.
Beautifully said, my friend. Beautifully said. Come, Percy, you hapless hound. Barely a boar worried. I do not know why I keep you in my employ.
What are your plans for Essex and your family?
There is much that is new.
Oh, Bearston. You promised we would never be apart. Not for one waking or sleeping moment. And already, you're sneaking out to hunt.
For the feast, Sweetling. We owe our mutual friend a great debt. One that I promised to repay over suckling pig and ale.
Sister, have you forgotten where you are?
I have a right to happiness, Elreach. Or am I to play nursemaid forever, you ungrateful pup?
Happiness, yes. But you embarrass yourself nightly, heaving and sweating with this hamhock.
Hold your tongue, boy. Lest we both speak our truths.
What truth have you to speak? That you've returned to this fickle man who abandoned you years ago for a Frankish pet? A woman he paid this Dane to abduct in that lammish shadow play?
Mind yourself, boy.
Or that you let him sniff and paw you, and take him to your bed on the promise of nothing? The whole of Essex whispers now! He's married still, his wife freshly stolen, and you are no more than... his...
I am the mother of his child, you whelp!
Child? Alvida?
Please, my boy,
I will never forgive you for this. Never.
My lord, joyous news. God smiles upon us this very day. Estrid has been found by Alfred's men. They ride to her rescue as we speak.
I will not let this plot be undone.
Nothing is safe till they are away to Francia.
I will fix this, and one day I will call on you, and you will come.
You can count on it, my friend.
I wanted to tell you so many times.
Hush, angel. Who's friend, sir?
He came safe. What have I done? We must go after him.
Estrid should have ruled this land. I would have followed her anywhere.
Are you leering at me, Lord?
Your Bearston's hired Dane. Do not think what you did went unseen. Yet tell me one thing. Is Estrid safe and happy?
She's happy. That much I know.
Good. Now leave. And if we meet again, you will fall by my sword.
Estrid is so close to freedom. I hope I'm not too late.
Rollo! Alfred's men have found you!
What? How can this be?
Lark, stand by Estrid. Guard her with your life. If she's taken, all is lost for us in Vist.
Come, lady. It would not do for them to take you back. Watch out!
Lark! Odin, no!
Release the woman, Danes! If she's unharmed, we may lose some of your limb.
Estrid, I promised I would free you of your life in Wessex. Frank here awaits your return. Go now, with Aegir's blessing.
I'll miss you, Eivor.
When winter is past, summer will come and wind you in a flowered skirt. For you are beauty, and shall not wither.
Goddess Freya, give me more of that.
Come, take care of her, Rollo Stoutheart. And if you find yourself on England's shores again, I will expect you in my hall. Good. They are safe.
Birsten got his end of the bargain, and Estrid is to Frankia. I should return to Ravine.
One begins a long time ago at a desert oasis, far away, a place of mystery, wonder.
Eivor.
In Essex, I played a matchmaker and a heartbreaker. An easy way to forge an alliance, but let us stick to war and diplomacy.
Understood. Thank you, Eivor.
Should we take this to your chamber?
No need.
You are a good boy.
Ronnie J, go stupid.
Blooper drop shit, drop on my blooper pop shit, pop on my keep a chop stick, chop with a big kick. Blooper drop shit, blooper pop shit, keep a chop stick with a big kick. Look at the gun on my little bitty bitch.
Do you feel the pull?